This one works.
No. Do it again. No. These are different. This one. This is awesome.
Digital.
This is X4,
this is
X4. Does that light go green when you click it? So that's working.
Hello, 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 very little. Hello, hello, hello. Hello, hello, a lot more. Hello, hello, hello.
Okay, no, let's see. This is actually getting a signal.
Yeah.
This one doesn't.
No.
So it's something between.
Showdown here in Grande Prairie, Alberta. Feature game tonight, Muirhead versus Middaugh. Two undefeated teams, and just so happens that I have a very special guest commentator with me tonight, Mr. Jeff Walker from Team Newfoundland.
Hello, everybody.
Hey, Jeff, how you doing tonight, bud?
Doing pretty good.
How's the
current
one so far?
So far so good. We're 3-1, so we don't play till tomorrow now at 12:30 against Team Stoughton.
That's perfect. That's just enough time to do some commentating and have a couple beers.
That's right.
Right on.
We'll see how I do.
So Jeff, how's your overall season with Team Newfoundland and Brad Gushu?
It's been pretty good. We had a little bit of a unfortunate briar. We were obviously.
You're going to tell me all the shots that they should and shouldn't play and make me look really smart. Is that okay?
Sounds good.
Okay, right on. Team Muirhead won. They draw the button, so that means they have Hammer in the first end here. Playing the yellow stones. Sure, Doss team has the red, obviously. Thank you.
couple seconds.
So far this weekend, Jeff? Ice has been actually really, really good. Been consistent draw weight, and we're getting quite a bit of curl for a curling club. We're, I think everybody's pretty happy with it.
Try and put on a good show for you guys here.
Yeah, doing a great job so far. I think I haven't heard any complaints from anybody, and if you don't hear complaints about the ice, usually curlers are happy.
Must be the skips then.
That's right. Most of the skips, I think, are. Well, I mean, obviously it depends on the record, but I think a lot of the, you know, you're seeing most of the top teams winning their games, and when you see that, usually the ice conditions are pretty good.
Sloan here.
Yeah, it's unfortunate she came up short on her last draw there with the host, or they would have had a deuce set up early, but now she's going to have to make this roll to try to get her deuce set up. Looks pretty close. I'm going to think that she might just roll underneath. It looks like she's rolling underneath. I thought she might roll to the open just because those two guards are pretty much wired. So if she does make this roll perfect, you can see Muirhead play the run back and stick it and be buried.
The Muirhead team has definitely the heat up their sleeve. They can throw the big ring when they want to.
That's right. Yeah, it's something I think they take pride in. A lot of the women's teams now are coming out, and a lot of them can bomb it pretty good.
Do you want? So
looks like she might have been a little bit tight. That's still behind cover though, and that's still not bad.
Yeah, I mean, it's undercover. Eve's going to use that to her advantage, though, and probably play the freeze right down to it here. She makes this good, and again, she might have her deuce set up.
Second stone for Anna Sloan.
This is, I guess, first third stone, I think.
That's correct.
And is the third on Team Eve Muirhead. Sorry to correct you here right off the bat.
It's okay. You're the world champion, not me. This is going to be tough for Shirley to get this out without losing her red one in there already.
She can get away with one that's going to be not too terrible to mention her, I think.
Yeah, I think so. I mean, she's gonna try to flop to the middle. She might be able to just rubbers and keep it around the rings. But yeah, she's going to try to, she obviously doesn't want to nose it because it's going to give Eve the pocket to freeze into. Yeah, you know, I just noticed that this weekend as well, that Lee was in the house, and she's a very good sweeper, so I'm not sure if she has an injury, or if she's feeling under the weather, or what's going on with that.
This could be a very likely possibility, as we've seen that with Brad Gushue's team and yourself in the players the other weekend. You were holding the broom, and what was going on there?
I just had basically a strained shoulder muscle. From the Briar, it was just a little bit fatigued, and the first game actually of the Slam, the first game about halfway through, I just felt a little bit of a tear, and I was getting some physio, and anyways, they said it was just a strained muscle. It just took a few days to get over it, and I probably could have swept on the weekend, but we were rolling pretty good, and we just decided to stay status quo for the rest of the weekend. Give me a chance to, you know, obviously sweep two less rocks in end, which helped me out, and also we didn't want to put ourselves at a disadvantage if I could only, you know, sweep at 70%. So this way we had, I mean, Brett's a great sweeper in his own mind or his own right, so you know, we had him sweep and he did a good job, and I used to skip at times and played third in junior, and so I was took a you know, a couple shots to really get the feel of calling line, but it seemed to come, you know, it came back to me pretty well.
So does Brett have anything to worry about? Do you think job position change might be in the future for Team
Grisha? We don't know yet. You know, we're happy with our results over the last couple of years, but I mean, with all the teams changing, there could be a lot of different things, and I mean, everybody's talking to everybody, so you never really know what can happen. But as of right now, nothing. We're still status quo. We're going to be playing the players together, and I'm sure there's going to be some more talks over the next couple weeks and even over the next month of what we'll be doing in the future.
Last rock here, man number one for sharing the dock. Looks like she's just going to try and draw down to the back one in the back 12 there.
Yeah, I think she's just trying to get one in front of it and force Eve to her single. It's completely buried, so even if she, you know, she comes up a little bit light but gets buried, it's going to be a very tough shot for two for Eve. So, but ideally she'll want to be right down to it. Definitely, she made obviously that one perfect, but yeah, it isn't shots usually practice. And obviously, in practice, you usually are drawing to the 4 foot, drawing around corners sometimes, but you don't usually draw to the back 12 to the corner very often. So, yeah, you're right. It's something the sweepers obviously got to be really aware of, especially in the first end. You know, you see a lot of the teams now. They're practicing basically the path to the button for the draw to the button. They want that path wore down and get that right up to speed right away. So you don't usually see the up the middle to the wing in practice very often. So it makes it a little bit tougher for the person throwing and for the sweepers to judge.
So how's the ice been? Has it been fairly consistent right off the hop here?
It has been. Actually been really good in practice. You know, it might be 4 to 6 feet slower your first few rocks in practice, but by the time the game starts, it's pretty much right up. Other than, like I said, the middle path can be a little bit slower, but only one or two rocks and it's right up to speed.
Final rock here, then number one, Eve Muirhead, puts it right in the 4 foot there for a single point. She goes up 1-0 over Sherry Middaugh. First end of play. Shout-outs that you'd like to thank for Team Gushu there?
Oh, definitely. Millions, yeah. I hope there's millions of people watching. Maybe I can have a future in broadcasting. I'll let them be the decision or the deciders of that. But, definitely ForQuest Energy has been our title sponsor over the last 2 years. And we don't have enough good things to say about those guys. They were fantastic. And they also sponsored the National Slam up in Fort Mac a couple weeks ago as well. They were one of the presenting sponsors, so it's good that they're getting into curling, and they've been fantastic, and like I said, they actually have a lot of their business up in Fort Mac, so it was actually a perfect fit, and you know, exactly like I said, we're so happy with them, and also our sponsor, Curline Curling Supplies. They've been with us now 3 years, or the 3 years that I've been with Brad, and they're fantastic as well.
Top four, it's usually the call on that first one if you're going into the house.
That is right. It's going to make it a little bit tougher to get the force here right off the bat. They're probably going to have to throw the guard. But unfortunately, they won't be guarding anything in the forefoot. So sure, we'll be able to either make a move on the back one or try to come around, depending on where the guard is. Not sure if she called that one top four or if she called a guard, but it is top four, but it's going to leave Sherry the hit and roll here. You make the hit and roll and you're going to be really close to the double as well.
Teams that are commenting on the weekend and on the tournament, and you can also see who our next featured game is that we are broadcasting and commentating on. Also, some of the results. So that's at Grande Prairie. Vicky Adams now looks like a routine takeout. You're gonna have to work pretty hard, being that that first rock in the back 8 foot to keep the juice alive.
It's going to be a tough force, I guess, for Eve when you start off with a few rocks at the back of the house and a corner guard up for Sherry. So Sherry's going to take advantage of the corner guard here now. If she gets one buried here, Eve will be chasing for the rest of the end. Lee Merklinger has a pretty good shot here. Can't quite tell from where I am, but it looks like it's probably 7/8 buried. Got a pretty good line, it looks like. Doesn't want to bounce off. Just got a good shot. That actually went. Yeah, I think she got a shot rock. That was a really good shot. I was surprised the rock actually bounced off that far. So.
We were noticing up here earlier today that the rocks seem to be finishing really nicely this weekend.
They are, yeah. I think obviously they were touched up a little bit before the weekend, but that's what a lot of the curlers want, is they want to be able to have the curl and that late finish. And I think, like I said, they touched them up, and that usually will result in a really good late finish. And usually they're pretty consistent as well. They're going to be probably straightened out as the weekend goes along, but so far we haven't seen that, and obviously we're almost at the end of day two.
For Team Middaugh. Looks like they're just trying the same thing, just trying to move the bells.
Yeah, Eve's still going to be shot rock here. Eve's got herself out of a little bit of trouble here. I mean, it's whenever you're going around a corner, it's never the greatest situation when you don't have hammer. But, you know, in this situation, she's got both of them in front, and she's shot rock and completely buried. And she's going to throw another guard on here. It's going to make it really tough for Sherry. Sherry's going to have to make probably a double peel on her next one, or depending on if the guard hangs out, she might be able to come around it. But if it's in a good spot, she's going to have to play the double peel.
Guard for the life and try and steal this end.
Yeah, I think you're going to see Sherry double peel here. It's not a lot of good other than the double peel. I mean, she could try that corner freeze, and it's a very tough shot. And even if she makes it, she likely could be forced. So. Oh, it looks like she might be playing just either the single peel or the double run. Not exactly sure what she called for. The double run, if she makes that, she could be in really good shape, but it's not not an easy shot at all. Not too far off by the way they're calling it. Oh, she's going to like this result. That's a really good shot. Got shot rock. Pop the yellow to where it's accessible. Like they can make that in turn tap. And knock that out. So that was Joanne. Yeah, Joanne Rizzo made that.
Joanne Rizzo with a beauty. Double run back.
Made that look easy.
Sure did.
All of a sudden that turns the end right around again. Now Eve's got to be very careful.
So it looks like Eve is motioning for Anna just to come in. And just kind of on the tee line, frozen, or trying to get frozen against the...
Yeah, I think she's trying to corner freeze one of those reds for sure. I think ideally she'd like to get around the one that's top eight, just tuck a piece under and get shot rock and not also protect her one in the back four. But it looks like it's hanging right now, so it might not be great. If this doesn't get to center line, Sherry's going to have a double and roll away.
That changes it again for Team Eve. Looks exactly what they're trying to do. Sherry's motioning for the double either way, trying to figure out which way is going to be best. Is the rolling any good here, Jeff?
Rolling isn't bad. I mean, it's great. You're going to be lying two buried. You could also play, the double and roll away, and you're going to be lying four. And, you know, Eve's going to not have a very easy shot. She might have to play the hit and roll, try to roll under. It's going to be a fairly long roll if Sherry can roll away. Or she might have to play the same intern freeze, which is obviously no gimme. So I'm not sure what she ended up with the plan A was, but there are a couple options. Looks like it's curling early, so I wouldn't be surprised if you see her play the inside roll. Oh, they went the whole way for the double. I thought they might get off that and try for the inside roll, but they went hard for the double and just missed it.
Well, kind of looks like Eve wants to try that new double now. Or at least a hit and flop.
Yeah, it's pretty skinny double, but the hit and roll in front to get second shot. I'm not sure if she can get... I guess she probably could get shot rock. It'd be tough to... She'd have to roll about a foot to get shot rock. If she rolls any farther, probably only second, but at least it'll probably take those other two red ones, I guess the third and the fourth shot out of play. If she can get that, even if it rolls 2 feet, she'll be under those two guards.
try to at least cut them down for the time being.
That's right. I mean, there's a lot of red in there right now, so she's probably gonna make this one. If she doesn't make this one and knows it, she's gonna have let Sherry play that same shot, that same double and roll away, and all of a sudden she could be looking at four on her last one. Really good shot, and she might have got shot rock. I can't tell from up here, but they're gonna look at it. If she got shot rock,
viewers looking at home, we don't know.
I'm sure Russ would be able to tell us if he was here. Well, Victor would anyway. I have a feeling that yellow is shot rock here. She's trying the intern draw right onto the tee line to make it a very tough pick out for Eve without jamming on the back one. It probably doesn't change her shot whether she is shot rock or not. If Sherry is shot rock, she could come right back to that one at the back four, freeze on that. I think Sherry has hammer here again there, Dan. But Eve will probably try to follow it down and freeze right on top, try to get out of the end and get the force. So Eve's made they've made a couple good shots this end to get out of it, and Joanne made that double run back and sort of turned it around once again. But if Joanne made the double on her second one, they would have been in absolutely fantastic shape to score multiples here.
Quick update for you over sheet number 7, Team Mike McEwen versus Team Scott Webb. First down, Mike gets his deuce, so he's up 2-0 over Scott Webb. Make sure if you're Mike McEwen fans and you're following along on Twitter, you follow us here at the Pomeroy Showdown as well. So our Twitter handle is at Prairie Showdown. Mike and the boys have been pretty vocal on the Twitter over the last couple days, and it's really good to see. We'll keep you updated on all the other sheets on the ice right now as the commentation continues. Looks like Sherry goes a little bit deep on that one. Does that open the door a little bit for Eve here?
Yeah, like I said, they're really looking at it to see who is shot rock. Because if Eve already is shot rock, she could play one in the top 12 and make the draw very tough for Sherry. Without hurting herself in any way. But if she isn't shot rock, you might see her try to play the same shot that Sherry just played and come T-line and make her try to pick it out. But the looks of the ice is they're playing the draw to the T-line, so make it very tough for, like I said, Sherry to remove that. And if she does remove it, make sure she stays. But I have a feeling they think the red is shot.
On the T-line.
Looks like they're calling for the freeze, actually. So they're trying to freeze it right on there. If they do make the freeze perfect, then Sherry will be forced 2 or 1.
Not a bad outcome, considering they were at a couple pickles this end.
That's right. And this one is hanging, so it's going to be interesting to see if it'll stay around for shot. Looks like it did. Now the question is if she can nose that and score 2. I imagine they will be measuring if it's that close. You know, I don't mind this call. I think she's just going to be throwing hack weight down to it by the looks of the ice that she's taking. Maybe a heavy, heavy hack and trying to get to the nose. She gets to the nose, it should be safe. Anywhere nose or even just a little bit low, and she'll be safe. And like I said, it all depends on who shot. It almost seems to me that Eve thinks it's Sherry, and maybe Sherry thinks that it's Eve, just because I thought that she would probably make sure that she removed this rock.
That was kind of where my question was going to be next, is why would you mess around with the curl and not just throw a missile down there and make sure it goes for sure?
These top curlers like Sherry, like they're not afraid to throw that soft weight. They got good enough sweeping, and if the ice is consistent, which it has been, you know, and they're comfortable and they're completely confident where they put the broom, they're not afraid to throw that soft weight. They're very good players.
I guess that's why they're curling and I'm up here.
Oh, Dan, I'm sure you could be playing in this if you got yourself a team together. You're out vacationing all the time, though.
That's true.
You're a world traveler instead of a curler.
Wow. You know, and that actually brings up a good point there, Jeff. I know some of the people don't get to have this one-on-one time with, a world curling tour event guy such as yourself and a Breyer guy. Curling is your life. You can't really do a whole lot, especially in the winter. There's no time for holidays and travel. It's pretty much curling just about every weekend.
Yeah, you know what? That's correct. It looks like it's red as we watch the measure here. So it's going to be two for Team Middaugh. No, but going back to that question, that was something that I wanted to do. I really started enjoying curling once I got competitive. And obviously when I was successful as a junior, and you know what, I just really fell in love with the game and wanted to stay in it, and now it is my life. I don't really have any holidays in the wintertime because curling is, I sort of take it as a holiday because it's something that I love to do, and we do a lot of traveling and been in a lot of curling clubs in Canada, I'll tell you that much. But it is, when it comes to the summer, that's when I do my work. I work seasonal, try to do something different. The last few years I've been at a golf course back in St. John's, and you know what? As far as vacation, I haven't went on vacation since I moved out to Newfoundland. I haven't, and started playing with Brad on a full-time schedule. I haven't had a full-on vacation where I've traveled outside of curling. So it is a sacrifice I made, but you know what, I really enjoy what I do. So it was something I thought, I thought to myself, you know what, you should take the opportunity while you get a chance.
Yeah, there's only a select few of us that can say they've been to the Breyer a few times done what you've done on the World Curling Tour and stuff like that. I'm sure all of us coming out of juniors, myself included, you have to really make that decision whether you're going to curl or you're going to, have a real life. And it's pretty commendable for those of us that like yourself that can do that. So good on you, man.
Oh, well, thanks a lot. I mean, I know there's a lot of great junior players they were great junior players, made nationals. And some have even won world championships. And once they get sort of out of junior, they get that 21-year-old age, they want to go out and they want to get an education and obviously get a good job and have a good career and get married, start a family, different things like that. And people have different priorities for what they want to do. And, you know, you got to respect those people as well.
Throws her first stone just over the hog line. Looks like Anna and Vicky really had to pound that one just to not make clear by rounds after the game.
I didn't think they were going to get that over, but they did a very good job. However, it is very high, and with the swing, it is pretty much, you could say, a useless corner guard. If anything, it's just going to get in the way of this outturn draw. Definitely a guard you're not going to probably see ran back very often.
So quick update here on sheet number 5 right next to us. Val Speed versus Zavenia. They're all tied up after two ends. And two apiece playing third. Notice on Val's team looks a little bit different this weekend as well. There's a few teams. teams that are looking a little bit different on the ladies' side as well as the men's side too.
Yeah, that's right. Looks like Vala's got Stephanie, I think they say the last name, Brer. Used to be Stephanie Jackson from BC filling in this weekend. Obviously, for the those of you who don't know, Joanne Courtney, who was on the team, has now joined Team Holman. And I think they just felt it was so soon from the news of that happening, they felt this weekend might be a little bit tough on them or a little bit awkward. So they looks like they reached out to Steph, and I mean, a great player. She was at the Scotties this year with Team BC. And filling in so far so good, because this is an A final that they're playing in.
Scott Webb, Scotty gets his deuce out of that one, so he's hanging in there against the leading money winner on the WTC.
Yeah, Mike McEwen obviously is a great team. They've been number one in the world only, I think, as little as 2 or 3 years ago. They were ranked number one on the order of merit, and having another fairly good season. By their standards, I mean, they might not think it's top because they didn't get to the Briar once again, but I mean, obviously a great team. They're always tough on the Bonspiel circuit and tough to beat. And Scott Webb, local team from here, got Les Sonnenberg playing third for him, who was a longtime third for Kurt Balderson, still is, I think, in the local scene, but a great player from Grande Prairie here.
You know, I was thinking earlier when I was watching that Manitoba final, I'm sure that Mike is just wishing that Jeff Stout will get hit by a bus one of these days so he could just get to the frickin' Briar for once.
Yeah, you know what? I mean, that his time's coming for sure. I mean, once Jeff does retire, and I mean, there's hints at it, in obviously the near future, you could see a team like Mike McEwen go same as Glenn Howard, 8 or 9 in a row. I mean, obviously Manitoba is a great province, and not taking anything away from the other teams there, but Mike McEwen is obviously they're a top, I think, 5 or 6 team right now in the world. So like I say, once Jeff decides to hang it up, or if he if he does get a new team like he's talking next year, you could definitely see Mike finally break through. Like what she's read here, I gotta look. She looks like she's probably just gonna be throwing a freeze. She might even be guarding. I'm not exactly sure what she called, but I think she'll be probably throwing a freeze on that top one, maybe trying to bump it just a little bit, change the angle. It looks like her red one is pretty buried. There might be a sliver open on the intern side. But if she could get another one in there, maybe bump that yellow just a little bit, change the angle just enough to maybe fire it over top of that red one, and force Eve to single this in. Looks like they were letting that one curl, so they were trying to play the outside to get, I think, a little bit low on that. But right now it's lined right up onto their own red. However, it is, let's say, 3/4 buried. You might see Eve just play a pick here, or the intern freeze. Depending on how much you can see, well, it looks like she might come up and get rip the guard. I don't think so in this situation because, you know, she would have to, stick it right there, and you're going to be running that other, the red one back. She would rather be running her own back into that pile.
Always a risk running the other team's back.
Yeah, exactly. If she hits that right on the nose and ends up sticking it right there, yes, she'd be shot rock, but she's going to have that red right in front of it. She would have two reds right in front of it, actually. So that was probably the smart call. You're going to see Sherry guard here for a couple. If they do end up slipping a little bit tight on the guard, you might see her try to fire one back into the pile and try to spill everything around a little bit.
Again, with these top teams here, it's very much like pool. There's always thinking two or three shots ahead of the game and trying to do as much setup as they can for this quarter.
Yeah, exactly. These guys play so many games, and they know, you know, it's almost seemed like they've been in every situation. Both skips are very decisive, and they know, you know, they 9 times out of 10 they call the right shot. It's I should say even probably 90 times out of 99 times out of 100 they're probably calling the right shot. So it's like I said, they're very decisive, and they know the game. They're very smart. They've seen, like I said, most of the situation so many times. So she might take a run at it this time because it is a tighter guard. Like I was saying, she might try to take a run at it, try to spill at least two of the reds out, and get shot rock.
Bit of bad luck in the Olympics there. I don't think they quite finished where they wanted to, but still overall pretty good showing.
Oh yeah, I mean they came home with a bronze medal, and they're obviously they probably went in like most teams. You're going to go in to try to win, being the defending world champions, they had some pressure on them to bring home that gold medal for Great Britain, and obviously their home country of Scotland. But there's nothing to be ashamed of when you come home with a bronze from the Olympics. Yeah, it looks like she's going to be doing the same thing. Probably not don't want to bring this one quite as tight. You keep it a little bit higher and makes that run back a lot tougher. If she makes the guard good, you might see Eve maybe try to pick that back one out. Try to get shot stolen. Almost square on here, so she's it looks like she's electing maybe play the tap. There is probably enough curl with the intern. I'm not sure with the outturn if she can make the tap and get shot rock. The other option, like I said, is she could try to pick that red one. She doesn't even have to pick it necessarily. She'd probably come down and throw hack weight and hit it and maybe stay around somewhere over in the back of the 12 foot. But no, it looks like she is calling for the pick.
Just make it disappear.
Yeah, you bet. You make this, and all of a sudden you shot rock, and Sherry's going to have a tough situation on her home, especially the steal, because, for the force, because Eve's going to have a draw both ways. Yes, it is to the button, but, you know, these top skips make that 9 times out of 10. You know, she's going to have a draw both ways, so Sherry's going to try to cut off the draw, either on the outside or the intern, whichever turn she feels Eve will have a better shot at making. that was very close to just touching the yellow. I don't know if she could have, but it was very close. Looks like this one's hanging. It's gonna leave Eve the draw for two.
This is still no gimme. The out turn is a little bit tricky because of that high guard that Claire threw up earlier there. That takes a little bit of the out turn away. I think it still might be there, but it's definitely tight. And she doesn't have a whole lot of room to play with on the in turn. She's gotta kinda the side of the 4 foot, so she's not going to a big target.
Yeah, it's definitely a small target with that intern. She could also elect to play the intern maybe across the middle and try to catch the side of the four. Again, you play it that way, you're running out of rings. It's a little bit of a small target as well. But like you said, the guard that Claire threw earlier right now, and like I was saying earlier, it could just make it a little bit tougher for them to make that out turn draw. But I think there still is room to do it. But again, you got to squeak it. Either way, it's going to be a small target.
Should have hogged that rock.
Turns out, maybe. Like I said, the very high corner guard lots of times doesn't help you very often, unless you're on pretty straight ice. When they're that high, you can come around and tap things out from both sides. And like I said, rarely are you going to be able to play a run back of your own stone. Looks like she is now going to play the intern across the middle, try to catch the side of the four. I like this call. I think there's just that little bit more, you know, a little bit more of the 4 foot to catch. And you throw T-line weight, or even back four weight, you're not going to be able to hurt yourself. Even if you do hit the top red, you're only going to bounce your own back a foot and you're still going to score your one.
Better chance, too, if he's just a little bit hot on this and he catches a piece of that top red, he can take some steam off and actually help him score that
deuce. That's true as well. She can't hit much of it if she hits... probably more than an inch. It's going to be tough for her to spill in and get two, but that is a possibility. They're on and off it a bit, so it looks like weight's probably close. It's all line right now.
Looks like line's good now. It's all right. Lead up to the sweepers.
It's really curling, so it's going to shrink the target, but I think she's good. It's a great shot.
World champion Eve Muirhead. Young
Looks like it's got a little bit of room here. It's got a lot of crawling to do. We played on this sheet actually earlier today, and it was yesterday. And this intern side coming home seemed to be a little bit straighter than the other way. So having a little bit of trouble getting some late finish and getting everything buried on that side. It's a great shot by Lee Merklinger. Eve's just going to play the straight freeze here. It looks like she has moved the ice in almost about a foot from the last one. So she realized on that first one that it is a little bit straighter.
Need a top four to freeze onto that red one. Really ain't good now. Looks like they found the line on this side of the sheet. Just need to get it in a little closer.
Looks like a beauty shot, yep.
Great shot.
Very good freeze. Sherry's going to either have to try to come down and try to tap the one that I guess Vicky just threw. Maybe tap it on a half a rock, just try to change the angle a little bit, or try to play this run back and change the angles around a little bit. That stagger in the front isn't really helping her that much. Yeah, it looks like they're going to play the run back, trying to hit this just a little bit off nose. Well, they might be changing the call. Yeah, just gonna be playing the run, it looks like. Just gonna try to hit this. Nose is probably pretty close. You might you're gonna roll the one you're running back a little bit over to the right hand side of the house as we look at it.
Is there a chance to roll this in, maybe? There is a chance to roll this in, for sure.
Yeah. She'll be the one that she's running back, try to roll in. It looks like this is wide though. She'd be lucky if she touches that yellow. Yeah, just over the top. So now it's going to be some guards for Muirhead. Looks like she might be looking at the possibility of making the double run.
Now, is the shot not there that
I like this call a little better. I don't really like the run that she was looking at before. She's just going to spill everything open and make it a little bit easier for Sherry to score in the end. Right now, yes, Sherry is sitting shot rock, but with that one that's frozen right on top, but she's going to have a very tough time getting two. And when it comes down to it, Eve's going to play the tap eventually and make it very difficult for her to even have a draw for one.
Yeah,
that one hurt. I think she's going to try to get as close to nose as she can, try to keep them lined right up. throwing very soft away. She's probably just trying to tap this to the back forefoot. Looks a little bit light. Yeah, a little bit light, I think, is the... She did rack, but I think it was mostly the weight that caused that rack.
So there's a whole lot of lemons in there and one lonely cherry. What does Sherry Middaugh have now?
I think Sherry's probably going to... The one that Anna just threw there that rolled up to the side, I think that Sherry's going to probably try to hit that and roll into them, roll right on top of the two that are frozen. I think that's probably your best call. She's going to hit it and looks like maybe try to roll all the way under.
Try and take advantage of that high right there.
Yeah, I don't mind this call. I mean, you want to roll it, obviously. You try to roll it in, whether you roll it a foot or you roll it 3 or 4 feet over. I sort of like rolling it right in front of the other one because eventually that one red one that's top button isn't going to be there for much longer.
Right.
This way, if you put that, get your red one on top, it's going to make it a little bit tougher when Eve plays the nose hit on that those frozen stones.
The guard on the left-hand side there, Eve's just going to play that shot again.
She's going to play that shot.
Anna won't miss it two times in a row.
Oh,
so
that's right. And they could play it again with soft weight if they really want to get aggressive.
You betcha.
Try to hit it right on the nose or even 7/8 high and keep the other one back four where they won't be able to hit that out without the jam. She looks like she got the shot that she called here. So
looks like it rolled a little far, and that's appears to be wide open for Eve.
I think you probably half buried, but you'd have a better angle than me. But it is third shot, which is key. No, it might. You're right. It might be closer to fully open because she's icing it pretty tight.
So Jeff, why would she go after this one instead of shot rock?
Well, right now she's sitting on top of the shot rock, so she's in pretty good shape there. Sherry's gonna have to do a lot of work right now just to score two. So if she hits this one onto the side, and Sherry does try to maybe bounce the ones that are top four around to get her due, they're gonna be close together, and Eve's probably gonna have a double.
So with Anna being a lefty, does that make that shot a little easier? Or does that come into a factor at all?
I was surprised that they were able to get that much to the inside of it on that one. And that
very, very tight to that guard.
Very tight to that guard. And it was her in turn, which is going to curl a little bit more, obviously, than a righty's out turn in that spot. It looks like now Sherry's going to play the shot that I was talking about, where she's just going to try to tap it, just tap it maybe a foot, get to the inside, and just change the angle a little bit. Looks like there could be a double. There could be a double both ways. She could play just the reds, or she could even play off her own yellow really thin, so in case she did get tight. But yeah, it looked like Joanne had perfect weight on the last one. It must have been just a little bit tight or ice just a little bit wrong. Even if Eve makes this double perfect, Sherry's going to have, it looks like, the double and roll underneath everything to get shot rock. Unless Eve can hit it thin enough that we should maybe squirt through and go to the back door and make it a little bit tougher, but I think it's inevitable. Oh, she is playing the inter. She looks like she might be playing it off her own yellow. Yeah. Very good shot. Still, no, it's still going to leave Sherry the hit and roll underneath, though.
Throw the big shots and all that kind of stuff. You guys played the junior team earlier this afternoon there, and is it still kind of humbling playing those guys? And I know they're probably pretty starstruck watching guys they see on TV and they're curling against them and stuff like that. So it's got to be still pretty fun doing that for you guys.
Oh, I mean, yeah. Anytime when, especially when we're playing the top teams, even now, I mean, you're still, you know, you gotta sort of pinch yourself a little bit in when you're playing in the Briar in front of, well, you know, playing a Jeff Stoughton or a Kevin Martin or a Glenn Howard. I mean, there's still teams that you grew up watching. And I was lucky enough to play on Wednesday in the Skins game with four-team Jeff Stoughton because Jeff wasn't able to make it, so I got to fill in that team. And that was just a lot of fun, just playing with those guys. And, yeah, like you said, playing even just the junior team. So I remember when I was a junior playing in this exact club where I, obviously the club I grew up in, playing most of my junior days, and playing the Kurt Baldersons and those guys I had so much respect for, and you know, it's just fun. I mean, those guys are in the same boat that I was. I'm not sure how they did it in the juveniles this year or the juniors for that matter, but looks like they got a few PCA crests on already, so I mean, look out for them probably in the future.
Those kids have done really, really, really well in our Peace Curling Tour that we have up here in the Peace Country, and they're going to be a force to be reckoned with as they get older and keep going with it. Fun stone here for Eve Muirhead and for them. It's like Eve's just playing another routine hit on her own here, probably rolling away, and she'll be 7-3, possibly 4 if she notices it, and give Sherry just the ability to drop the one.
Sherry's got to draw to the forefoot here for one to tie the game. You know what, I think so, yeah. She was in a little bit of trouble early. Yeah, she was in the top four, but with that rock of memes sitting right on top of it. Well, you really got to go here, it looks like. You really got to go. It's close. It looks like it. I guess I shouldn't answer that question quite so quick. You might have jinxed her, Dan. That is a very tough break. They were on it, looked like, right out of her hand.
You've got to be smiling inside a little bit on that one,
I would say, and it's going to be very tough. They're a very good hitting team, so it's going to be very tough for Sherry now to claw her way back, especially in an 8-end game. I mean, half the game is over now, and she's already going to be down 4, so pretty big deficit here to come back.
So we were talking about that in this afternoon broadcast, about the 8-ends versus the 10-ends, like you guys would play in in the Briar in the world and all that kind of stuff. Do you guys find it tough to adjust? Because I know you do play a lot of the cash wheels, which are all 8-end games, versus the 10-end games. Because really, in an 8-end game, your fourth end is a huge end for you as far as determining kind of how the outcome of the game could possibly go.
Yeah, no doubt. You know, I don't think you really it really affects you. I mean, everybody's in pretty good shape as far as the sweep and the stamina goes. But yeah, as far as the strategy, scoring in the 10-end game in the 6th and the 8th, and really managing the scoreboard is really key. Versus the 8-end game, it seems like you score early is really the key. A lot of times you can get up and start playing the defense right away. Whereas in the 10-end, if you could give up a 3 in the first end, and it's actually harder sometimes on the team that's trying to defend that lead for 9 more ends. So, and I mean, the ice surface is so good in a lot of the events that we play in now. And, you know, I think a lot of the curlers are really, really liking the 8-ends. It seems like teams get at it right away. They're not hitting, you know, for 2 or 3 ends and just trying to get the ice ready. And but having said that, I really like the 10-ends in the Briar. You know, playing in the Briar and the championships and, you know, the Canadian and World Championships and that sort of stuff. The 10-ends, I don't really want to see it going to the 8-ends. But I do like on the cash bill circuit, the 8-ends. Just a little bit different. And, you know, you just got to think about it when you're managing the scoreboard a little bit as a skip. But, you know, as far as the game and the strategy, it doesn't change a whole lot.
For sure, even all right now, this was a 10-end game that, you know, 4-point deficit wouldn't be as big of a deal, but because this is only the 8-end game, she's got to really pick up her socks now and really put together some good shots.
Yeah, exactly. Like, they're definitely going to need a deuce this end and probably at least a steal or two along the way. But yeah, in a 10-end game, she could get a deuce here and get a force and get another deuce and get a force, and all of a sudden she's right back in the game with a steal of one. So in this case, she's probably going to need at least a couple steals.
So another point to bring up, you know, from the 4-MAC weekend there, 4-rock rule.
5-rock.
Sorry, 4-5-rock rule, yep. Versus the 4-rock rule. What's what are your feelings? I know there's a few mixed opinions out there. Some people say that, you know, it's a lot more interesting for us as fans. How do you feel as a curler? How does it make you?
You know, it's a lot of fun. Same sort of thing. I don't really think you need to see it being changed at all, but it's a ton of fun. You don't see near as many blanks, especially in an end. You know, if you see an end where they're running up and down the sheet, you're going to see the regular blank. But in the 5-rock rule, you usually see, especially the teams down, you see the two corners can't peel the corners, so they're almost forced to throw a guard, and it's very tough to see a blank after, you know, once you're hitting second stones, and it just creates a lot of offense. It's very tough to defend getting a deuce, and it changes the strategy a little bit when you come down to the end. You know, now you like to see teams in the 4-rock rule being one up without coming home rather than being one down with hammer. But in the 5-rock rule, you'd actually rather would be that one down with the hammer, because it's so tough to defend giving up a deuce. And just the fact that they, you know, you can't be peeling the guards. You got to probably make two double peels or two big doubles at some point along the way. It's pretty exciting. It creates quite a bit of offense. I mean, if you execute, there's going to be a lot of offense.
Little Vicky Adams here with a little hit and stick. No, 3 yellow rocks in the house for Team Muirhead right now. I would assume, like you said, Eve being such a great hitting team, they're just going to probably blast away these next few runs, and hopefully they can keep it pretty clean. If they give up one and get the hammer back, they'll probably be pretty happy with that.
Oh, definitely. I mean, they're going to be, you know, they're not probably too concerned if they give up a deuce here. They're going to do everything they can to get the force. But, yeah, I mean, right now it's just eliminate for them. And then making sure they score with hammer. That's going to be key for them as well, making sure they score when they do have the hammer. And right now they're going to have the hammer in the even end. So that's obviously another big advantage.
these three yellow rocks in the house. Does Team Middaugh keep on putting up guards? But we just answered that question.
They're on that, I guess you get second stone, but there's the three yellow in the house. They're going to try to use those in order to create their offense. You know, you throw a few guards up early hoping you get maybe a miss peel early on, but once you get to this point where there's all these rocks in play, you can generate a deuce with just using these rocks. It's a lot of stuff that Eve can jam on.
Adjust me on the computer at all? Or?
No, because it's all being outputted from this box as one signal. So it's the input.
Looks like Joanne's playing a soft weight bump here on the frozen stones on the button. She's just trying to, looks like probably only get second shot, but get one in there and make it tough for Eve, make Eve deal with it.
sure what they're going to do here, though. It doesn't really look like a whole lot of options for Sherry. What do you think, Jeff?
Yeah, they're in a little bit of trouble here. It looks like they're probably going to have to maybe put another one, try to get one, another one in that crotch, in that pocket on the left side of the forefoot. I'm not sure. Can't quite tell from here if Red is already shot. If Red, if Yellow is shot at the back, they might need to jiggle those around a little bit and try to get Red shot. But I'm thinking freezing that pocket, as long as the pocket's not too big that you can knock it through.
Just gonna say corner freeze on that outside yellow one. That doesn't seem like too terrible.
It doesn't seem too bad. You definitely shouldn't see that one go. You might be able to still pop the other red one out into the side of the eight. Like I said, just because it's at the other end, it is tough to exactly tell the angles. But she's gonna definitely have some work to do to try to get her two out of this.
Rest of the boys out in Newfoundland are listening to us tonight and watching the game.
Yeah, you know, I got a, you should actually say buys, not boys,
that's
but I got a couple of messages from a couple of buddies out there saying they're listening to me, so I'm going to give a shout out to all the buys out there. And I should mention their names here. I got John, I got obviously teammate Brett Gallant, John and his girlfriend Amanda, I think Sam is there. I think Patrick's there. I'm not sure who's all sitting at the house, but I imagine they're trying to stay warm. They had a pretty nasty little storm out there over the last few days.
I'm sure there's some beer or rum helping them out with that.
Scotch.
Scotch.
Or Screech, I should say, not Scotch. I don't know if anybody drinks Scotch, but my buddy John here, he sure likes his Screech, so I'm sure he's having a few of those tonight. Yeah, just trying to jiggle it around. I think get shot rock. Try to keep as many lined up. Oh, she might rack. That might not have been a bad actually result. Not sure if they can make that red double, but gonna make it a little bit tougher to get that red that was shooter there that rolled into the middle of the crotch. That's gonna be a little bit tough to remove. Might have been a little bit fortunate. I'm not sure what she was calling originally. Red is gonna shot rock now, and the other red could be difficult to remove. Also got to give a shout out to my buddy Matthew. I excluded him from everybody. I wasn't sure who was at the house. I had to recheck my message. Yeah, that's right. So I better say hi to Matthew as well. He's been filling in for me as far as I know for my mixed league back home. So I'm not sure how they did without me, but usually they win without me. I'm just a nobody in that league. So I expected nothing less than a mixed league victory at her club. So hopefully they were able to pull that out. I haven't heard. It's been silent, so I'm sort of thinking maybe not, because I think if I would have heard if they had won.
That was a
very good shot. Very good shot. She's gonna have a difficult time getting to and even scoring at this point. I think Eve's pretty happy with the situation right now.
Yeah, Jerry Middaugh is just in a pickle right now. Just the body language of the team is just signs of I have no idea what the heck to do right now.
Exactly. It. She's probably thinking, geez, I'd like to give Wayne a call right now.
Wayne or Russ?
Probably Wayne. He can throw it a little harder.
Yeah, there you go. End of the season, Wayne might be either working on his golf swing or trying to get one last snowmobile ride in right now.
Yeah, you know what? I think he is a pretty avid snowmobiler, so that's probably the case. He's probably out snowmobiling the last. I don't think the weather's been great in Toronto either, so or the Toronto area, I should say. So he might be out snowmobiling. Either that or he's down somewhere south golfing. You usually see Wayne a few times during the year. He's got quite the tan going, so usually he's down somewhere. Not sure how much he practices anymore.
Yeah.
Usually he practices his golf swing, I think, a little more. Don't blame him.
Yeah. When you put your dues in like that, you kind of pick and choose.
That's right. Looks like Sherry's finally came to a decision here. I think she's just going to play the straight back on her own red one. This way it looks like she could probably get second shot and third shot. It's hard to say what the best call is here. In this situation, the best call is just trying to get as many as your red ones, I guess, as close to the 4 foot as possible and hope that Eve misses.
This is when the Hail Mary comes into play.
No, that's right. I think with that ice, looks like she's probably only throwing a board weight or trying to nose it, like I said. And if she can nose it, and if she is possibly lying second and third, it might not be a terrible result. Definitely got to hit curl, though. She does not want to hit this high. It's going to be pretty close. I think she's going to like that result. Like I said, it all depends on if she is second and third. The yellow at the back left of the 8 foot could possibly second or third. Not quite sure, but
I guess. Like there's some angles there that. I thought Eve might try and go after that double at the front of the house there, but looks like she's just electing to try and play off that red one on the wings.
Yeah, I think she'll hit the second shot over there. What I believe to be second shot. And try to roll in just a little bit or roll way under where it makes it so it's a tough double for Sherry. If she hits that one, the best Sherry's going to do is have to make a double to get two. And like I said, at the start of the end, she would be okay with Sherry only getting two this end. Keep hammer into the even ends, playing six end. If she can even score one, she's still got a pretty good hold on the game. Apparently our play-by-play man's mic isn't working very well, so it probably just sounds like I'm talking to myself here. We're trying to get that issue fixed up. This game might be over, in fact, before that mic gets fixed up is the only problem. All right, Sherry's going to look like she's throwing a double here on her last one.
Well, judging by the rock that's out front first, it looks like it is Eve Muirhead with another steal. So this... Oh, yeah, it looks like you're right, actually, Jeff. Right, right. High guard here thrown by Lee Armstrong. Now, if I'm reading this situation right, because I am a lead, throw the high one and then throw the second guard in behind there a little bit tighter is probably the play for Sherry Middaugh.
Well, that's exactly right. That's a very good high guard. Right splitting on the center line. It's only within a broom length from the hog line, so you can't get much better than that, really. It looks like they're just drawing open side here. No, they might find the tick. No, they're drawing open side. Couldn't quite tell there for a second what they're doing. Just hanging out.
Set them up for the steal real nice.
Over on sheet number 7 for you. Mike McEwen versus little team Scott Webb. Blank in the 6th end. Mike McEwen still up 1-3-2 over Scott Webb. Sheet number 5, Al Sweeting versus team Tarantoni. Swiss team is up 1 over Val 4-3 and they are playing. Keep it nice and simple. There, sit two in the middle, shot rock, and second shot rock. hurting them right now is the sun. Throwing that other guard up now, trying to replace the one that Mickey Adams peeled off.
Yeah, throwing the second guard. He's going to probably take her out and double. There's a little staggering, but it's like she's just going to go for the single peel. Thought she might take a run at it, but go for the single peel and probably see one more guard from Sherry, but then she's probably going to have to make a play on the one in the house. Or see if she can somehow tap it. It looks like it's pretty buried, so it's going to be tough to tap.
So I was seeing earlier that center guards are really the only things that's hurting Eve Muirhead's team right now. They've got two in the house shots, shot and second shot, so probably just see him keep on peeling those guards. And unless Sherry makes a real big move into the house, which it looks like she's actually doing right now, trying to draw right on top of that one in the top four.
Yeah, for sure. For Eve, it's just going to be eliminate. And Sherry's going to do whatever she can to try to get some more cover, some frozen. I thought she might throw one more card, but I don't disagree with this call. We're in the heel turn of the face right now. This is the side that will curl a little bit more, it seems. So I'm just surprised she can get right to the face of this. On it early for the line. It looks really tight. I think she's laid in tight here. Just want to try to line this up so at least if the double peel might go back into everything. It might have lost it. It's close. Maybe you'll mate so far back in jam, but I think she'll still get that one over the top.
Probably just a little on the high side of the game. Is that right, Jeff?
Yeah, high side if she plays the yoke turn. It should drag a little, so she probably is going to hit the yellow. Just not sure if she can throw enough weight to still get it out of the box. She hits it really thin, it'll definitely drag it. Could even nose the top four. I think there's only about an inch separation. It's probably definitely coming back into the top one, no matter what. Just a matter of time. Hard enough to still get it out of the rings. We'll see some heat here from Anna.
Back at the junior place, we were picked off the end boards on that one.
I was probably one of the few that didn't do that. Oh, we hit one. She just over. Just as everybody went, amongst the crowd here. One of the sweepers went down and she hit six. So it appears to be all right. Don't think we'll be rocking for it. I did miss, when that happened, I did miss. She made the double peel with the end of the jam. So very good shot, man.
Yeah, that's right, Jeff. I had made a beauty of a shot there. Just ticked that one in the top four as a free buy, but made everything nice and clean, and Sherry Dawes is chasing the pen.
She's going to have to make a really good freeze here in order to force Eve. Eve's looking pretty good right now. Score, no guards in the play. She can throw it hard enough that even if they weld it perfect, she can probably still get it spun out of the ring.
Just a straight tick here for Anna, or are they going to try something a little fancier?
Yeah, straight pick's good. Also, she can probably hit three quarters of it and it'll go, and keep the shooter around. Looks like that's what she's going to call, try to hit and roll. She doesn't mind if she loses that one on the same line. She probably wouldn't prefer to lose the one that's on the T line there. now it allows Sherry to throw the guard. Brings the possible steal back into play. You're still going to have the draw to the full four, but at least I mean, it's still going to be game on. It's looking like game over there for a little bit.
Really unfortunate breaker for Addison. He clears every yellow rock out of the house, loses her shooter and everything. Tough one, but the end's still in play.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, she's going to have to draw the forefoot on her last one if she needs to. All depends, too, on how good this card is. Sherry's going to have to have this card currently.
My mom watched it online. Is it alright? What was the feel of that? Very short.
You're good with the hammer, though.
Oh, yeah. Pretty good. It might be a little bit high. No, it's going to be dark here. It's going to be high enough that I don't think he's going to work. I don't think she's going to be able to see anything. She might take a run. Yeah, looks like she's going to play the run back, try to one chance at making that. And the thing is now, if she does make this run back, she could possibly roll right to the center line, which give Sherry the draw of the top button and maybe a chance of a steal. So we'll see. I think she's probably smart just to put the straight peel here. She knows she's probably going to have to draw the 4 foot. The 4 foot if she makes perfect guard for her one. Or if she misses the guard, maybe.
Yeah,
I'll
get it. First rock here, 6-7 for Muirhead. Oh, yeah. Not quite sure if she's playing.
Ooh, looks like she's going to peel. It's a little wide.
A tricky section of this ice that they're dealing with though makes the peel okay. So that's going to open it up. I'm assuming Sherry's going to try and throw a second guard up there again to make it a little tougher, and he's going to have to draw to the full floor to get her one, which, like you said earlier, Jeff, that's all they're shooting for is they can get out of here with one that's a good end.
Yeah, you bet. Like I said before, just wants to score with hammers. Looks like she's going to play a straight guard. Another option, she could try to come in and just get a bite in, just so she has that second one in case, he shorts hers or throws a little bit in. Trouble is, if you do it and come just a little too far, even if she does bite, you might try to throw the double. I don't think Sherry would, but to this point, she tried the double and gives her a chance of a bite. She probably makes the draw the 4 foot more often than she makes the run back. Don't worry about it. Mine's good, I need to actually try to get a biter here. I'm content with the straight guard, and it looks like it's perfect, so she'll be drawing four back.
Great guard again by Sherry Middaugh. Muirhead here, final rock in the sixth end. Just drawing the open 4 foot, yeah, gotta get full four to get the point. Other updates going on here. We have sheet number 3. Another nail biter with Team Pillsworth versus Connolly. They are all tied up, playing the 7th at 3 apiece. Young Ginter and Jim Moore. Two young teams again. Ginter playing the 6th end is up 4-1. Final snow being thrown here on our feature sheet. Muirhead. It's 4-4. Sweeper's just dusting this thing. Definitely not heavy, not light.
Live games.
Looks pretty good. Gets a bite of the button for her single. Score on sheet number 4 for feature game. Sherry Middaugh, Muirhead. Muirhead up 7-3. Playing the 7th end now.
Yeah. Do you have a... Do you ever do like a
check other scores. Other scores. They'll bring up all the sheets and all the updates. Don't leave it up the whole time, but just take it down.
Oh, so you did this. This is what you see now.
Yeah, yeah, this would be on the stream. I imagine that would be in the way. But if you're curious,
yeah, I know. I was going to fix it earlier and forgot to hold my thing.
If you want to see, though, it's even just right here, too. So, I bet you're curious.
He can just update sheet 7 and 8.
Take that over on sheet number 7. Mike McEwen gets his deuce in the 7th end. He's up 5-2 over Scott Webb. It's going to be a tough one for Scott to come back on this, get 3 points in the last game against Mike.
Maybe if you want to talk louder, they can hear the people talking. They can't hear your announcing. You've got to tell them they want to hear your announcing. Hey, I'm terrible, Mike.
Yeah,
I'm going to hear your
announcing.
Yeah, he's got Mike teaching. I thought you guys are the best announcers, better than Nick and stuff. No. No.
Throws the first one, top 12. You choose to check the second one through the house. Keep this one nice and clean. And do we want to give Sherry a point here, or are we trying to steal the ball?
They'd be loving to give Sherry one. They don't even care if they give her 2 points. They're going to do everything they can. Give her two or less, be happy. I'm actually surprised that dropping her first one at the top 12, but instead of throwing it through, they didn't just try to peel that one out, because it's not going to really help them at the top 12. It's giving them good things. So the ice is swinging enough, they can get around that. Actually, I mean, life a little bit more difficult. I'm going to try to even up these guards here. Two corner guards, straight across, so we know double deal. And then just slowly start to plug away. If Team Middaugh makes every single shot this end, they should be able to get their deuce. Go peel guard, eventually go around the corner. And see a peel, and they'll guard that one. And eventually get 2 degrees. Being that the one is in the top row, top four, they won't even have to hit it for a while until maybe last shot, if at all.
Sherry Bernard's going to come in the house now. You can finally make that move. Here. Looks like he's going to do the double run. Smith's Jeff's call, I should say. I eliminated some talk right on the phone. I think that was mission number one. Looks like Sherry's going to try and come around again. Hiding for everything she can. Just trying to make generate that deuce and get back in the zone. Upstairs for some beers, I would think, for both things. No, really good games. Really impressed with Scott Webb's team. They've come a long ways this year as far as they're playing on the tour a little bit, and they're really hanging in there against those big teams. They're going away until the seventh end against the Rainbow Team. I'm sure they had them on the ropes a few times there.
Can you hear background noises in today's
this. That's why we haven't been able to.
The good mic's not even plugged in.
So hopefully our technical difficulties is over, and Jeff and I haven't been talking into nobody for the last 20 minutes. Playing the seventh end here, Eve Muirhead versus Sherry Middaugh. First rock here for Sherry Middaugh. Just trying to draw around that top yellow rock that's top of the 12 foot, like Jeff was saying earlier, and I'm not sure if anybody heard or not, but we're seeing that rock in the top 12 wasn't exactly the greatest shot in the world because it's still with the swing ice can draw around.
Yeah, I was saying earlier they threw the very first rock that went top 12 there. It's a little bit short, and they threw the Team Sherry Middaugh through the corner, and then Eve decided to throw it through. I thought maybe they would peel that rock because it's only going to be a nuisance, and now it is coming into play. If Sherry was able to get around there, it would have made it a little bit difficult for Eve, but obviously they came up a little bit light there. Now he's going to use that to her advantage.
So hopefully our technical difficulties is over, and Jeff and I haven't been talking into nobody for the last 20 minutes. Playing the seventh end here, Eve Muirhead versus Sherry Middaugh. First rock here for Sherry Middaugh. Just trying to draw around that top yellow rock that's top of the 12 foot, like Jeff was saying earlier, and I'm not sure if anybody heard or not, but we're seeing that rock in the top 12 wasn't exactly the greatest shot in the world because it's still with the swing ice can draw around.
Yeah, I was saying earlier they threw the very first rock that went top 12 there. It's a little bit short, and they threw the Team Sherry Middaugh through the corner, and then Eve decided to throw it through. I thought maybe they would peel that rock because it's only going to be a nuisance, and sure. Now it is coming into play. If Sherry was able to get around there, it would have made it a little bit difficult. Very often when the team's down four, a little bit hit, but now he's going to use that to her.
You know, Joanne came a little light on her last one there, and that's the one they're running now back. And Eve was able to go around that,
and it forced her to play the shot. And she made it, but now Eve's going to do the same thing. She's going to get around there again, and Sherry's going to have obviously Sherry's going to probably not be able to get two. It's going to be very tough for her to get to. She's going to have probably a difficult shot for one. Oh, and you're going to actually see handshakes.
There it is. Handshakes all around. Eve Muirhead takes the victory over Sherry Middaugh. Final score in this one is going to be 7-3 because they did not finish the end. Oh, I'm sorry. They did finish. That's going to. That's Mountain Step. Very short. Terry is apparently questionable. Thanks very much for tuning in, folks, and we will see you tomorrow. And thanks very much to my co-commentator, Jeff Walker, lead for Brad Gushu. And for coming out, and welcome home, Jeff.
You know, thanks for having me, Dan. It's always great to be back in the city and area where I grew up. So, thanks a lot.
First rock here.